Hi, my name is Umar, and today we have first generation Toyota IST. Brought to us with the courtesy of Fahad, who is one of our subscribers. A huge shout out and a thank you to Fahad for giving us this car for review today. Our Instagram is bamwheels.com. You can follow us on Instagram if you want to see what cars we'll be reviewing in future. IST was first introduced in 2002 and it stayed in production till 2016. The first generation was replaced in 2007-8, something like that, with the second generation. And after, in 2016, when the car was discontinued, the successor of IST is Toyota CHR, which is the crossover. Now, this is a hatchback, but this hatchback is powered with a 1300 and a 1500 cc engine. So unlike the regular 1000 cc hatchbacks, if you want a little bit more power staying within Toyota, this is what you can have. As usual, I'll show you all the features of this car and then we will take it for a road drive. So when you come to the front of this car, this is your front headlight, where you have your parking light over here, this small one. Over here is your indicator light, and this hole is the low beam and high beam headlight. Here you have fog lights. This is the logo for IST. If you remember, we have discussed this before as well. In Japan, the front logos of the car, specifically with Toyota, they are different for each car. So a Passo has a different logo, a Vitz has a different logo. This is the logo for IST. Apart from that, there is nothing much to talk about in the front. IST comes with 1300cc and 1500cc engine options. The one that we have for review today is a 1500cc engine. This is one NZFE, which is 1500cc, 109 horsepower with 141 newton meter of torque. And this car comes with an automatic transmission. When you come to the side of the car, you don't have much. It's like a plain side. You have indicator, aftermarket alloy rims, and that's pretty much about it. The side skirts, yes, this is a design element of the car that you get. It does affect the ground clearance of the car, but these are something that you get for a design element. Look over here, you have this glass entire at the back, so this gives you like a glassy feeling. This is connected with this, so the rear pillar is covered in glass. So when you enter the car, the first thing you have is your power window controls. Now if you notice, these are the same power windows that you used to get in the 88 Corolla, then the Indus Corolla. They're the same controller, so nothing is changed as per the controls. Now over here you have your front speakers. When you look over here, you have your fog lights, your defogger, and your door mirror controllers. Now this is like a standard variant. The loaded one does come with the retractable door mirrors, but since this is a standard one, you don't get the retractable door mirrors. You have this little storage space under the steering, a three-spoke steering wheel. Now this is the same steering wheel that you used to get in the third generation Passo, the one with the front bench seat. You get the same steering wheel in that car as well, the first generation Passo with the bench seat. Now in the center you have your speedometer, the RPM meter, and fuel gauge. There is this digital cluster over here. One more thing that I would like to mention with this centered speedometer in this car, like the position of the speedometer is in the center of the dashboard. This is kind of an odd placement for this car. The first time it came was, in as per my knowledge, the first time Toyota introduced this thing was in their first generation of Toyota Vitz, and that had a digital speedometer which was a little tilted towards the driver. this one has it like straight facing the entire car, so when you're driving the car, the reading from the dash speedometer and the instrument cluster, that is a little difficult. You need time to get used to that. In the middle you have your navigation screen, underneath manual climate control, then this is one storage space that you have like this, then you have this another storage space, and then you have a third storage space. Well, in terms of storage space, you have a lot of storage spaces in the dashboard itself. You have two cup holders, your automatic transmission. Now this gearbox is the same gearbox, like this entire thing is the same that you used to get in the first generation of Toyota with, so it kind of reminds you of where the car is heading. Your center console. Now over here under the dashboard, again under the glove compartment, again you have this little storage space. You have your glove compartment. When you open your sun visor, over here you have one vanity mirror, no vanity mirror on this side, one dome light over here. Now when you talk about the materials of the car, this is plastic, this is like a little mesh fabric, plastic kind of a mix kind of a material, again plastic. Multiple colors and multiple kind of textures have been used to give this car a decent premium kind of a look. The car has manual seat height adjustment as well. These seats, these are not like the leather seats are not factory fitted seats, these are aftermarket seat covers, but if you look at the profile, you have this thigh support over here, you have this lumbar support, so the seats have been designed to give the cushion to make it extremely comfortable. Okay, so now we are sitting at the back of this car. Really decent headspace. Three people can fit in, a little like next to each other, but they can comfortably fit in. You have these headrests, so that is also comfortable. The leg space, I mean, this car is good space in the rear seats. That's what I would say about this car.
Coming to the back of the car, you have your tail lights with the indicator and reverse lights and the main tail light over here. Now this light was changed in 2006 when the facelift was offered. Also in the loaded variant of the car, you get a rear spoiler over here, but since this is a basic one, you don't have that. You have a rear wiper, a regular antenna, pretty basic. So you open the trunk and you have this decent sized trunk, so like compared to a normal hatchback, this is a little bigger trunk. You have these two flaps, one of them is for your some extra tools or something like that that you can keep, this one is for more tools. And if you take both of these out, let me just show you, you can take both of these out and then you have your spare wheel right under there. These are all the features of this Toyota IST. Now let's take this car for a road drive.
Now we are driving this Toyota IST. Now this car has a 1.5 liter engine, so obviously the power to weight ratio on this car is extremely good. I mean, I cannot tell you how good the pick is on this car. Now apart from that, the driving position, if I talk about the driving position, like I'm sitting extremely comfortably in this driving position. I do miss this handrest, like this armrest in the middle. That is something I miss. The braking is good, the car has ABS, so the braking is of course really good. And so pickup is really nice. Now the body parts of this car are not very easily available because this isn't a common car, so the body parts are not very easily available. However, the engine suspension, this is all shared with other Toyota cars, so engine suspension isn't something that you need to worry about. And I just love the way you just accelerated and the car goes.
The rear visibility is a little compromised because of those the design of the D pillars and C pillars. So the rear visibility is a little compromised. However, the front visibility is very, very decent. Now this is a 2002 model car. Because of that, you do feel that these door mirrors are a little small by the standards of these days. However, at that time, this is how those door mirrors used to work. The car is good on fuel since it's a big engine and small body car, so the fuel economy is good. You can easily get about 12, 13-ish when you're talking about the fuel economy. Resale wise, these cars, like, these are not your everyday cars. These are cars that only certain people would prefer to go for, who want to get a little extra from their hatchback. So yeah, the resale is not as fast, but it's not a disastrous resale either. The running price for the first generation, if you look at, so you can, the price starts somewhere around 700,000 rupees for these earlier model ones, and then it goes up to something like 1.1 million rupees for the cars that are the later models, or the cars that are the facelift later model cars. The thing to write home about is the acceleration, which is extremely good and extremely smooth. So you just accelerate and it goes. One more thing that I would like to mention about this car would be the comfort. So the seats are really comfortable, and that's something you kind of enjoy about this car.
This was all about our review of this Toyota IST. Please let us know in the comment section what you think about this review. Till next time, bye.